Here in Wabino?
Yeah.
Is that so? Who owned the mill?
The Menominee Bay Shore.
The
Lumber.
Same company?
Same company, yeah.
And you say this was one of the largest mills in the United States?
It was the largest at that time.
Well, how many men were working in this mill?
Well, I don't know exactly.
Well, was it down on the river here?
Yeah, well, it was on my river, yeah, but it's about a mile from here.
About a mile east of here?
Yeah.
Well, what river is this?
This is the north branch of the Ocano.
The north branch of the Ocano. Well, then they had a pond down here, a holding pond.
Right.
The Alexander Stewart Lumber Company Mill at Wausau about 1900. The east channel of the Wisconsin River lies in the foreground, and Rib Mountain looms in the background. It is here that George Stevens built his first up-and-down sawmill. The mill crew and horse barns at Sawmill in Wausau on site presently occupied by the Wausau Mall. Water barrels on the ridge board of this building were an early form of fire protection. Selsich and Wilson Lumber Company Mill at Star Lake. Silo at right was a slab and sawdust burner. Here is the bull slide with a single log ascending to the second deck of the mill. Hatton Lumber Company Mill on Wolf River at New London about 1915. Rice Lake Lumber Company Mill with a log boom running into Rice Lake. The Henry Walksmith Lumber Company Mill at Bayfield, overlooking Lake Superior. The lake lies to the right in the foreground.
I'm speaking with Nils Olson at his home in Mason. Well, now, when you first went into the woods, when I say into the woods, did you actually go into a lumberjack camp?
Yes.
And where was that?
At Odena.
Odena. And what were you doing that first year? Were you 15 or 16 or what?
I was 16.
16. What was your first job in the mill?
Well, picking stock in the lath mill.
Picking stock. Now, what does that mean?
That's the lath, and that's the slabs and edgings.
Right.
To make wood lath.
To make, I see, yeah. Okay. And how much were you making?
Yeah. See, there was 10-hour days then.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
And
I was making 3 1/4 a day, so it was 32.5 cents an hour.
I see, yeah. Sure. Well, now, did you get bored with that?
No.
Oh, no wonder.
No.
Because
we paid $8 a week for board and room.
Yeah. Well, now, where did you get that? In the village or in the company camp?
Yes.
In the village.
Larson's boarding house.
Larson's boarding house.
Yeah. What of course, they had a company boarding house too.
Sure.
Merit was $6 a week.
Mm-hmm.
But food was much better at Larson's.
Well, then after you've been doing that for a while, what was your next step? Did you go upward?
Yes.
What was the next upward step?
This was the lath mill. I wanted to get out of the lath mill, get into the main mill.
Right.
So my next job was catching edgings. That was behind the edger.
Right.
And you caught these edgings as they came through and threw them off the table down on the side because there was chains that went through there to the slasher where they cut them off in 4-foot lengths.
Cut them with the slasher.
Yeah, right.
They cut them in 4-foot lengths.
Yeah.
Right.
And then... From there, I went to the trimmer and straightened lumber on the trimmer table.
Right.
And then, this was during the war,
yeah.
So there was lots of chance to work overtime.
Oh. Tell me, what was your most interesting incident when you were working in the mills? Do you recall anything that was outstanding that you never can forget when you were working in the sawmill?
Well, the association with the lumberjacks, I think was the best. They were not afraid of hard work, that's one thing. They knew they had the hard day's work to do and they did it with a smile, you might say.
Right.
Yeah. And in Odena, it was a lot of Indians working there and we got along fine.
Mm-hmm.
I had some very good friends, young fellows my age, that we were really friendly. And
Now, the Odinas, are they part of the Chippewa tribe?
Right.
The main sawmill of Knapp, Stout & Company at Menominee. John Paul Lumber Company Mill on Black River in La Crosse. And the Holt Lumber Company Mill at Oconto. The close-up shows a portion of a plank wall mentioned earlier used to contain a hot pond.
I'm talking to Mrs. Diane Schmidt. She's the curator of the Chippewa Valley Museum. Mrs. Schmidt, I understand you grew up in logging camp country.
Yes, I did. I grew up in the Nicolet National Forest around Lakewood, Wisconsin.
And your grandmother and grandfather were loggers?
My grandfather was a teamster in the woods out of Gillette, Wisconsin. My grandmother cooked in the logging camps, and my dad logged in the winter for something to do. Whoa. And when I was a little girl, he would take me to the logging camps, and I would watch him logging and skidding.
Skidding logs to the landing.
And the cook would cook for me in the bunkhouse.
Yeah, that was your grandmother.
I beg your pardon?
That was your grandmother, the cook in the camp?
Well, by that time my grandmother was dead, but I had a great uncle, a Plishek, and there are still Plisheks up around there, who was a cook up around Newell.
Around Newell, yes.
Mm-hmm. And he would take me in the kitchen and make me French toast and put it on a tin plate. I thought that was really great.
Well, do you remember anything else good about that cook shanty? What else did they have that was good to eat there?
Oh, they always had lots of food. And, of course, you know, the reputation was if the cook wasn't good, the men weren't happy, so.
That's an old story.
Yep.
You don't remember the name of the lumber company your grandfather worked for?
No, I
wasn't
don't.
Holt Lumber Company.
No, although the land that we built our home on was purchased from the Holt Company after it was logged over up north.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew Mr. Holt.
You knew one of the original Holt family.
Yes, I did. Mm-hmm, I knew.
Which one was
I didn't know his first name, but ultimately my folks built a resort and a restaurant, and the grandfather Holt was often brought in to eat in our restaurant.
Here is the Northwestern Lumber Mill at Eau Claire. The Eddy Creek Mill at Couderay. And Emerson Mill near Cable. Note the company housing at left. And the Owen Lumber Mill at Owen. Mr. Rosholt interviews Al Niles at the Tillida Dam and Sawmill on the north branch of the Embarrass River in Shawano County.
Tell us a little bit about the history of the mill, Mr. Niles.
The mill originally was built in 1878 by William Dumpke, an immigrant from Germany. The life of the mill has been the building of Tillida, the surrounding area. The mill itself has a good history because it's been productive up until about 1957.
The mill was still running in 1957?
The mill was still running, as far as we know, the last running of it was 1957.
And they weren't using the water power at that time, were they?
Yes.
Yeah, they were still using water power.
The turbine is still in good shape.
Oh, a water turbine.
Yes. Yeah, the turbine is in the bottom of the mill, mm-hmm. and it's still usable. Settling of the mill has made it so that the gears don't match well enough to saw lumber with it now.
Very good. And you're trying to save this, aren't you?
Well, we're quite sure that we can because we've created some interest through the public, the Historical Society, and a group called the Preservation of Mills Association.
The Hudson Lumber Company Mill on the St. Croix River at Hudson. The city of Oshkosh, located on the Fox River at the mouth on Lake Winnebago, attracted the largest concentration of sawmills in the state of Wisconsin. Lumber, lath, and shingle mills along both banks of the Fox River were so numerous that Oshkosh became known as Sawdust City. The Northern Wisconsin Lumber Company Mill at Ashland. Here is a trainload of lumber, lath, and shingles manufactured by the Eau Claire Lumber Company. Destination, Omaha, Nebraska. We are at Neopit, where the old mixes with the new. Here is the ultimate in sawmill technology, the largest in Wisconsin, operated by Menominee Tribal Enterprises. The first stop for logs brought in from the yard is this debarker. The debarker has wheels studded with carbide cutters, which pass over the length of the log and remove bark and sand. From the debarker, logs travel up this bowl slide to the second deck of the mill where they wait on a deck for sawing. Here, inside the mill on the second deck, there are two bandsaws in operation. The conveyor in the foreground drops the slabs to the first level of the mill for processing. The mist around the bandsaw is not sawdust, it is a water spray for cooling the saw blade. The rough lumber, after it has been sawed to the proper width, is dropped onto this conveyor, which will move the boards to an end trimmer. The end trimmer saws the boards to the proper lengths. The lumber, as it leaves the trimmer, goes for grading. The lumber grader turns each board, looks for defects, and grades it accordingly. The higher the grade, the more valuable the lumber. Mr. Rosholt interviews Wendell Irving, who is the personnel manager for Menominee Tribal Enterprises.
Would you tell us, Mr. Irving, about this lumber here?
This lumber right here will be going to Japan. It is a test run that we're making on our hemlock. And as you can see, the packages all have to be a certain dimension. If you notice the white tape on there, that has to be exactly 14 inches from the end, the same way with the other end. That's the way the Japanese are kind of particular on how everything is packaged. It seemed like the neater the package you have, they look at the lumber on the outside, but if your package is neat, they'll buy it right away. See, this goes out to the West Coast.
Yeah.
And then from there, it'll be shipped directly to, I think it's three different cities in Japan.